t'en fous.
Shortly before 9 o'clock a.m. this morning today, the call was received of shots fired in front of 1116 Ocean Drive, the home of Gianni Versace. The information that we have developed so far by the Miami Beach Police investigators is that the victim, Gianni Versace, was returning from a nearby restaurant and was in the process of opening the gate of his in front of his residence. A man described as a young white male dressed in a light gray or white shirt, dark shorts, white cap, and wearing a backpack, shot the victim and walked away. There was apparently no robbery attempt involved. Miami Beach Fire Rescue units responded to the scene and transported Mr. Versace to the Jackson Memorial Rider Trauma Center, where he was pronounced dead. Miami Beach investigators, together with agents from the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, are working together, currently interviewing witnesses and employees who work at the Versace residence in an attempt to learn a motive for this shooting. We're all appalled and very upset at this crime, and our condolences are extended to the Versace family. We ask your assistance in getting the word out to ask anyone who has seen anything or has any information concerning this case to call a special hotline number that we have set up at the Miami Beach Police Department. And that number is 673-7915, 673-7915, or Crime Stoppers at 471-TIPS. Thank you very much.
Headquarters in New York.
Good evening. Fashion designer Gianni Versace was murdered today, gunned down outside his mansion in Miami Beach, Florida. Versace was a fashion icon. His empire spanned the worlds of the famous and perhaps the infamous. Investigators are probing whether he was targeted by organized crime or perhaps a serial killer. Our CBS News coverage of the death of the designer begins at the scene of the crime with CBS News correspondent Jim Axelrod.
The blood on the steps of the most famous house on Miami Beach belonged to one of its most famous residents, designer Gianni Versace, murdered this morning.
I saw Gianni Versace laying face down on his steps with his head blown off, with his face shot off. Looked like execution style, shot in the head right on his steps where that blood is.
I do know it's not a random act of violence we would traditionally see, such as a robbery.
Police say Versace was targeted on his usual morning walk. They're looking for a white man in his mid-20s. The FBI has joined the hunt, identifying a number of suspects, including Andrew Cunanan, one of their 10 most wanted, suspected in four other murders across the country. This pickup truck, stolen by Cunanan, was found just blocks from the murder scene.
As far as Mr. Cunanan, he's been one of our top 10 fugitives now for several weeks, and we have been looking for him across the country.
In many ways, Gianni Versace and his fashion embodied South Beach, colorful, flamboyant, and vibrant, if not a little decadent, as he himself pointed out.
I like to spend money. I don't have respect for money. It is just paper for me.
This edgy appeal favored Versace and the part of Miami Beach where he made his home. After years of decline, Versace led South Beach to international prominence, the American Riviera. At the murder scene today, concern that the blood of Versace would stain what's been so carefully cultivated here.
So when you take the most famous house, the most famous residence, the most famous street, in the most famous vacation town in the world, the repercussions are pretty heavy.
Which is why within hours of Versace's death, the mayor of Miami Beach called in reporters to assure the public the area was safe, the killing not random. Right behind finding the murder of Gianni Versace, the priority is maintaining the energy he helped create here. Jim Axelrod, CBS News, Miami Beach.
Gianni Versace.
Versace's gone because he's like what they call fabulous. And when it gets to the ghetto, it becomes ghetto fabulous. And that's what the style is. It's ghetto fabulous. So Versace is definitely a loss to, you know, urban America as well as the rest of the world.
He makes very sexy clothing. So that's one of the reasons why I wear it, too. And it's because that's what I like. And everybody's wearing it. So be in style.
And it's got the alligator print in it. You know, it's like, you know.
Can you, I guess it's a mirror that we're dealing with.
Shopping or something.
Just talk.
Yeah.
You want?
Yeah. But this is a very Versace look because it's very beautiful colors and very innovative. I mean, he was very creative and very much.
Now here's another look at this morning's top stories. The FBI is searching for the killer of designer Gianni Versace. Versace is being remembered as a fashion giant. He was gunned down in front of his Miami Beach home yesterday. The lone suspect in the Versace killing is Andrew Cunanan. Cunanan is on the FBI's 10 most wanted list, sought in four other killings. Cunanan's mother describes him as a high-priced homosexual prostitute. The murder of Gianni Versace has sent shockwaves through the trendy Art Deco neighborhood where he lived. Andrew Colton of our Miami station WFOR is standing by now with the latest from Miami Beach. I see candles behind you. What is the reaction there in that area?
Just a lot of surprise right now, referring to the candles. Thousands of people have been coming out all night long. You can see it back here. Candles, cards, flowers, just messages of support for Versace, a man they say was so important to this community and the world.
Andrew, what is the latest on the investigation?
Well, it seems to be an all-out effort right now looking for Andrew Cunanan, the alleged murderer, the suspect in this case. Police and the federal investigators are not sure right now whether he is still in South Florida or perhaps has left the country. But right now it is an all-out effort to try to find out exactly where he is.
One of the interesting things that has come out about Versace is he really believed that he was above being robbed or killed or anything. So this must be extremely shocking in a neighborhood that thought to be itself to be safe.
It is, but interestingly enough, we spoke to a number of tourists overnight who were out here coming out to the scene to ask them what they thought about that, and they say that because it sounds like this was a targeted situation, a situation that was targeted just for Versace, that they do not feel unsafe walking the streets of Miami Beach. They don't think that it's going to give Miami a black eye that so many people have spoken about. They're just very sad that this has happened, but don't so much feel that this will happen to them.
What kind of hole does this leave in the fashion world?
Well, from what we're hearing right now, a very large one, specifically here in South Beach, where it is a small fashion community, but one of substance nonetheless. Those who are in the industry say Versace was a huge supporter of it, someone who would do anything to help it out, and now that he is gone, they are wondering just what the future of that will be here in Miami Beach.
Thank you very much, Andrew Colton, for taking the time to join us so early in the morning.
Sure.
He's with WFOR-TV in Miami.
Newz headquarters in New York.
Good evening. Hundreds of police and FBI agents are searching tonight for the man suspected of murdering fashion designer Gianni Versace in Miami Beach. He is the same suspect wanted in a cross-country murder spree that began this past spring in the Midwest. Police have received hundreds of tips about where Andrew Cunanan might be, but the search is concentrating in the Miami area, where CBS News correspondent Jim Axelrod begins our team coverage.
While candles and flowers pile up where Gianni Versace was murdered, a manhunt is on for the suspected killer.
I think it's certainly a possibility that he's still in this area.
He is Andrew Cunanan, described by investigators as the only suspect. Yesterday, police impounded this truck blocks from the murder scene. Cunanan is suspected of stealing it. CBS News has learned investigators found bullets of the same caliber that killed Versace inside the truck. A distinguishing mark on the bullets, apparently made by Cunanan himself, matches marks found on slugs taken from others believed murdered by Cunanan.
I'm not going to go into any of the evidence that we have.
Police won't talk about evidence, and they won't say if Gianni Versace knew Andrew Cunanan. But Versace was gay. Cunanan reportedly moved in big money gay circles in California. While investigators don't make any connections yet, others do.
Maureen Orth is researching a magazine article about Cunanan. She says Versace and Cunanan met backstage at the San Francisco Opera several years back, and it was not their first meeting.
And Cunanan was thrilled that Versace recognized him because they had been someplace at some time before. And then from then on, Cunanan always bragged about knowing Versace.
Eddie Bianchi, a neighbor, also suggests that Versace may have known Cunanan. He saw Versace, his assistant, and a third man arguing. Then Bianchi heard the assistant talking with detectives after the murder.
When I heard the other guy walk into the house with the police, he said, like, we've been arguing, you know, like, it's something personal.
If investigators can also link Versace to Cunanan, That could be the final piece of evidence needed to rule out anyone else. Jim Axelrod, CBS News, Miami Beach.
Even before the Versace murder, Andrew Cunanan...
All over the country looking for this fugitive, Andrew Cunanan. So far, he's the only suspect in the Gianni Versace murder investigation. Police believe Cunanan gunned down the world-renowned fashion designer at the front steps of his South Beach villa.
The FBI and the Miami Beach Police Department and Crime Stoppers have been receiving tips on Cunanan, so the FDLE, FBI, and Miami Beach are actively pursuing all of those leads.
Like connecting Cunanan to the case, this pickup truck, it was recovered in a parking garage not far from Versace's home. Witnesses say they saw the suspect run into the garage. Police found bloody clothes under the truck and traced the vehicle to a New Jersey cemetery caretaker, a man police believe Cunanan murdered 2 months ago.
Everybody's at risk. Everybody's got to help us put this guy in jail.
Andrew Cunanan is a suspected serial killer. He has been connected to 5 murders from Minnesota to South Florida. Before yesterday, his name and face could be seen on the FBI's most wanted list. Now, his name and likeness can be seen in newspapers and on televisions around the world. Peter Ajay, the man on the right, received a rude welcome to Miami within an hour of arriving here from New Zealand.
The arresting officer had his hand on his gun holster. So therefore, I didn't know what was going on, and they did the usual thing, hands on the bonnet of the car, and patted me down.
Police took Ajay into custody after he was spotted on a street corner by an officer. Even Ajay admits he looks like murder suspect Andrew Cunanan.
Yeah, basically I do, but I telephoned my sister back home in New Zealand straight after what happened, and I said, hey, Trish, they think I'm a murder suspect here.
Even though Cunanan's picture is in every local newspaper and on wanted posters throughout South Florida, he has a fairly common appearance.
The reason I look at it, I just wanted to make sure, because on TV you really can't see what he looks like.
Police now suspect this stolen red pickup truck Cunanan drove down here sat in a Miami Beach parking garage since at least June 10th. So he's likely had a place to hide out, and police believe he's still here.
We're going to assume that he's here until proven otherwise. And we don't have any evidence, any concrete evidence, that he's out of the city of Miami Beach.
It is a normal day on the streets of West Hollywood, except there is a heightened fear and concern about the fact that suspected killer Andrew Philip Cunanan is still on the loose and may come back here. Look around West Hollywood. You'll see Cunanan's wanted posters in windows and outside of stores.
Is he here? Is he in West Hollywood? Is he? He's been allegedly spotted in Beverly Hills this morning on Rodeo Drive in front of Versace's store. It's conceivable he got on a plane immediately from Miami, flew to LAX, and is around here.
At Marvin's Pharmacy, Lisa Wilcox has Cunanan warning posters up as well.
It's just very scary to have it in this community, because it's a very quiet community, and I don't think a lot of things like this happen around here anyway.
Scott Hutton agrees.
I think the thing that's kind of scary about the guy is that it's almost like he has no identity or any identity he wants. And I guess something else is that he doesn't look like a serial killer. I don't know if there's like something a serial killer is supposed to look like, but he just has kind of a innocent look about him.
We just handed out wanted flyers, Andrew Cunanan. Okay. So you've probably seen him on the news.
Connections in different parts of the, you know, world. So, and this latest murder, I think he just wants to be, you know, in the eye of everyone right now.
All eyes are indeed on Andrew Cunanan right now. The Versace murder has once again pushed Cunanan and the Hillcrest area where he hung out into the national spotlight. Keith Robinson has been a close friend of Andrew Cunanan for nearly 2 years. But a couple of months ago, he says he noticed a change in Cunanan.
I know that he was having money problems at the very end, and says as far as I've known him, he's never worked before, and he always like picked up all the bills and stuff.
Robinson says Cunanan always picked up the tab at dinner, even when eating at some of the most upscale restaurants in Hillcrest, like California Cuisine. Robinson says Cunanan often bragged about having money and being from a wealthy family, including his mom.
He would like say that she was like very wealthy, and they had a house in Rancho Santa Fe just for artwork, and another house in La Jolla to live in, and that they were very, you know, happy.
Well, right now, Cunanan's mother is renting the small duplex here in National City. The manager told me she moved here about a month ago from Chicago. But before she left the Windy City, Cunanan's mother told a Chicago newspaper that her son was a homosexual prostitute. a statement Robinson says he finds hard to believe.
But then I heard all the things about him, like being a prostitute and stuff like that. And one thing I'd like to say is, like, as long as I've known him, he's never, you know, been, like, you know, overly sexual to, you know, anyone. He never, like, picked up people at the bars, never, like, you know, did anything like that, that, you know, he wasn't like a town, like, tramp or anything like that, what everyone's kind of picturing him out to be. We even, like, often wondered if he was even very, you know, if he was homosexual at all.
But now, Robinson says he and his friends wonder how this will all end for Cunanan.
A lot of people, at least the closer friends, don't think he's going to be coming back, you know, and we don't think that he's ever going to get caught. If he does, it's going to be like a, you know, kind of a bloody thing. He's going to go down fighting.
That it could come in as far east as the Florida Panhandle. There was a funeral in Italy today for fashion designer Gianni Versace and a memorial service in Miami Beach, where he lived and died. As the hunt goes on in South Florida for his suspected killer, no one is sure where the elusive Andrew Cunanan might be. But CBS News correspondent Jim Axelrod has exclusive information tonight about where he might have been.
4 days after his brutal death, Gianni Versace's family brought his remains home to Italy. Those who loved him in Miami Beach gathered to say goodbye. Since yesterday, investigators have turned their attention to the Normandy Plaza Hotel in Miami Beach. CBS News has learned that on May 12th, a man fitting the description of Andrew Cunanan checked into the hotel using a last name similar to De Silva, an alias of his. That was 2 days after police discovered the body of a New Jersey man they believe Cunanan murdered before stealing his red pickup truck.
But the truck was there, the red truck.
Desk clerk Miriam Hernandez said the man was driving a red truck with South Carolina plates, just like the one recovered Tuesday near the Versace murder scene. Hernandez says this man stayed in several rooms like this one, often wearing a baseball cap and carrying a backpack. Eyewitnesses to the Versace shooting said the suspect was wearing both. After the man checked out last Saturday, another employee found fashion magazines and a hair clipper. Hernandez is convinced the man was Cunanan.
Because one night he take the glasses off, and now I can picture him completely, the smile, everything.
Hernandez says he stayed in this third floor room all day and went out each night between 10 and 11. In 2 months, the man only let maids clean his room 3 times.
I get the creep, you know, because the guy was very nice. You cannot think nothing wrong about that guy. Believe me, nothing. Sweet, quiet, he come and he goes. He mind his own business, he don't bother nobody. And a sweet person, sweet guy, you know, and now we put everything together, sure.
While investigators will not say anything yet about the possibility Cunanan was at the hotel, the owner will. He says a SWAT team raided the place yesterday, suspecting that Cunanan was on the premises. Jim Axelrod, CBS News, Miami Beach.
Good evening. I'm Anthony Mason, sitting in for John Roberts. The hunt for Andrew Cunanan, wanted for the murder of 5 men, including Gianni Versace, keeps taking bizarre twists and turns. As Jim Axelrod reports, police think he may be able to completely alter his looks.
Andrew Cunanan is a man of many faces, adept at changing his appearance. Now, Miami Beach police warn his disguises could include dressing as a woman.
It's very difficult for him to hide, so I wouldn't put it past him to do anything that might disguise his identity.
Since the Versace murder, investigators have said they believe Cunanan is still here. Today, they sounded a bit less sure.
So he could be anywhere in the country, could be out of the country by this time.
But do you have any direct evidence to link him to South Florida since the murder?
Not that I'm aware of.
In the thriving gay communities of Miami Beach, law enforcement's uncertainty is not playing well.
But certainly every time the door knocks, now I peek in the hole as opposed to just winging it open because I can't see who's at my front door.
That anxiety is also on display in the New York fashion world. With the men's spring clothing show set to start tomorrow, security's been increased for high-profile designers. Investigators are also continuing to try to establish a motive. AIDS counselor Michael Dudley says Andrew Cunanan came to him with concerns about high-risk sexual practices.
He got sort of agitated and got up and kind of kicked the wall and said, if I find out who did this to me, I'm going to get them.
But a writer for a gay newspaper in San Diego disagrees that AIDS has made Cunanan into a vengeful killer with a death wish. Nicole Ramirez Murray says a couple of failed romances unleashed the rage in Cunanan.
These two rejections made and brought forth a time bomb that exploded. A time bomb that I think that was in him for a very long time.
Uncertain about Cunanan's motive and current location, the FBI is taking no chances, warning a list of wealthy gay men across the country they believe to be potential targets. Jim Axelrod, CBS News, Miami Beach.
Anxiety.
News 2 o'clock report. One of the biggest manhunts in U.S. history is over. Police confirm Andrew Cunanan killed himself aboard a Miami houseboat. Live team coverage straight ahead. Plus, will all the focus on the gay community result in a backlash? We will have reaction from gay rights advocates.
Also ahead, the Television Emmy Award nominations are out. Are your favorites on the list? You'll find out next. And
you're watching the home of Southern California's most honored local news, KCAL 9, Los Angeles. It's 2 o'clock, time for today's latest local and world news, KCAL 9 News 2 o'clock report.
Tonight, all across the nation, our citizens can stand down and breathe a sigh of relief. The reign of terror brought upon us by Andrew Cunanan is over.
The reign of terror ended today when police confirmed the body of Andrew Cunanan was found on a Miami Beach houseboat, ending one of the most intensive FBI manhunts in U.S. history. Good afternoon. I'm Jane Velez-Mitchell.
And I'm Dave Clark, in for David Gonzalez. 3 months after Andrew Cunanan allegedly began his spree, it is over.
The manhunt for Andrew Cunanan is over, but their murder investigation into this killing spree is still open. Many questions remain, even though Cunanan's body was found in a houseboat just 2.5 miles from where Johnny Versace was gunned down here in Miami Beach. As Cunanan's body was removed from the houseboat at 6:45 this morning, authorities were relieved that Cunanan only made it 40 blocks from where the last victim in this killing spree was gunned down.
The fact that Cunanan was still here speaks leaps and bounds about the effort and the dragnet that was about for the capture of Mr. Cunanan. I think he was a desperate person with very little room to move about.
Cunanan reportedly died from a self-inflicted gunshot wound to the face. A .40 caliber gun was found near his body, the same type of weapon used to kill three of the alleged five victims. Just how Cunanan ended up...
Entry was made into the houseboat, at which time a white male victim was located.
That victim, possibly the man wanted by so many around the world. It appears the manhunt for Andrew Cunanan has ended on a Miami Beach houseboat.
To the end, he was cunning and smart, and he was hiding right here on the Gold Coast on Collins Ave, hiding in plain sight.
Police telling us the body of a man fitting Cunanan's description shot himself reportedly in the head with a .40 caliber gun, the same kind of gun used to kill three of Cunanan's alleged victims. One of those victims, Gianni Versace, the man whose death ultimately made Andrew Cunanan a household name. The eyes of the world became focused on this houseboat late yesterday, as SWAT teams moved in on what was first believed to be a burglary suspect barricaded inside the houseboat. The boat's caretaker first encountered that so-called burglar. He ran away, telling police he heard gunshots from a man who looked like Andrew Cunanan.
Here's another one.
Police used tear gas to get inside the house. At first, police said no one was inside. But a few hours later, a body is discovered. And soon it's reported Andrew Cunanan is dead.
It's a good thing because no one else is going to get hurt. You know, if he would have got cornered or something like that, he might have took a lot of and had to go out in a blaze of glory or something like that.
Obviously, it has turned out to be his last stand. I think he was personally sick of running. After you cold-bloodedly killed Johnny Versace in broad daylight, where are you going to run to?
From the moment he stepped off the plane from Miami, Fernando Carrero was greeted as a hero.
I was out for 20 years. I'm very happy to come back.
Are you happy to get the reward tomorrow?
Yes, I do.
This visit is part of a legal battle over reward money as caretaker of the Miami Beach houseboat where Andrew Cunanan committed suicide. It was his call that led police to the man they've now declared the serial killer responsible for five murders.
We need your signature.
While many believe Carrera's entitled to the $65,000 offered by the FBI on hotlines here and in Florida, only the New York-based Gay and Lesbian Anti-Violence Project has agreed to pay Carrera the reward they posted, $10,000.
He didn't have to call the police, but he did. And that call made a huge difference in this case. And that's the kind of behavior that we want to hold up in this city.
Clearly, others share that view. At the airport, they were literally fighting for Carrera's attention.
That's what I don't want. This is what I don't want.
What are you?
Let's move out. Move out. I don't want this. Be civilized, ma'am.
You're not civilized.
Through it all, he remained calm.
Admiral Carrera hopes to use the power of his newfound popularity to pressure the mayor for New York City's reward tomorrow. That appears to be an uphill battle.
He did not use the TIBS hotline.
Can he convince the mayor to change his mind?
Well, we found out.
Give him the money!
The caretaker's attorney, now suing to recover the rest of the reward money, displayed a police reward for public service the 71-year-old received here years ago.
He's very happy to be back in the state of New York. We didn't expect to get this kind of big welcome here.
It is a welcome likely to continue throughout the week. Sue Keenan, UPN 9 News.
Among developments tonight in the Andrew Cunanan story, the German owner of that Miami Beach houseboat in which Cunanan committed suicide is in custody tonight in Las Vegas. He is being questioned by the FBI. For tonight's Eye on America, the question that may never be answered in the Cunanan case, why? What drove him? Some self-described experts have called him a serial killer, others a spree killer. In the end, it appears Cunanan was in a category all his own, as CBS News correspondent Anthony Mason reports.
The people who study killers and why they kill were not surprised. They always expected it would end like this for Andrew Cunanan.
This man was a desperate fugitive on the run, and it was heading for a brick wall, and it finally got there in that houseboat.
But criminologist Robert Ressler profiled murderers for the FBI.
I ran away from home, as you know, when I was 19 years old.
Among others, he's interviewed John Wayne Gacy and coined the term serial killer.
Whatever your belief as to why he originally killed his victims.
Clint Van Zandt came from the same school. He spent 15 years tracking killers with the FBI's Behavioral Sciences Unit. They agree Andrew Cunanan was not a serial murderer.
I see a serial killer like a long fuse, and you light that fuse and it just burns and burns and burns and burns.
Like Gacy, over 7 years he quietly killed 33 men and boys before police discovered what he'd buried under his house. Cunanan, the profilers believe, began as a classic spree killer, acting violently and emotionally over a short period of time. 4 murders in just 2 months.
That should have been enough for him, but it wasn't. And I think that's the question is, why was that not enough?
Why did Johnny Versace die? For Van Sant, this was where the pattern broke down. This was the killing that still confounds many experts and defies any category.
This is someone who committed, intentionally committed, an in-your-face type of crime. He went out of his way to leave his name, photograph, everything else he could to identify him with the crime, totally unlike a serial killer.
And if he stalked his victim, unlike a spree killer. But Ressler believes there may be a simple reason.
I firmly believe that Versace, on the day that he was shot, met Cunanan, possibly at the coffee shop up the street, to tell him, leave me alone, I'm not going to assist you, I want nothing to do with you, and walking back, was followed back and shot in front of his residence.
They have questions, of course, the experts. For Ressler, the answer is somewhere back in San Diego, 6 months before Cunanan's killing spree began.
When his house of cards began collapsing, I'd like to know the things that impacted him, the things that broke down his ability to not handle the stress.
Most they make it their business to know
he
these things.
Well.
Why did Andrew Cunanan kill? He isn't here now to answer their questions. In New York, I'm Anthony Mason for Eye on America.
A reminder that you will see and hear more about late developments on the Cunanan case tonight on 48 Hours. That'll be at 10 o'clock in the East, 9 Central Time. For example, we're working on this fact, and it is a fact that the man who owned the houseboat is being questioned by the FBI in Las Vegas. That and much more about the case on 48 Hours tonight at 10, 9 Central Time. For the CBS Evening News, Dan Rather reporting. I'll see you again soon on 48 Hours. Released the 911 tapes today from moments after Johnny Versace was shot. The call is from Versace's cook inside the mansion.
911
emergency. Yes, man's been shot. Please, immediately, please. He's walking in front of his home. This is Johnny Versace. He was entering his house. We just heard gunshots. We went outside. He's on the steps of the house. He's not moving. He's not moving.
For the next 9 days, investigators followed up hundreds of reported sightings across the country. The FBI now says Cunanan went quickly to this houseboat several miles north of the murder scene and likely never left. He was hunted and alone.
It might be hard to believe that Mr. Cunanan could be on the run by himself without any assistance, but then again, that's very likely that he was in the Miami area alone doing these things.
Jack Campbell is the owner of a nationwide string of gay spas. He says he first met Cunanan a year ago in San Diego, and then again 2 months ago in Miami.
His appearance was so different between August of 96 and May of 97. It was caustic, flippant, not charming at all.
Campbell says the last time he saw Cunanan was the end of June when he turned him down for a job after Versace's murder. An angry man Campbell believes was Cunanan kept calling his business and threatening to kill him. Andrew Cunanan's body was cremated today, but it is not known yet when the ashes will be returned to family in California. Meantime, it is becoming increasingly unlikely that results of an AIDS test done on his body will ever be made public. Jim Axelrod, CBS News, Miami.
In Alaska, the